This video series is to introduce website development to beginners who don't know anything about making websites. If this particular video seems too easy, click the first link in the description to go to the next one. The methods in this video may not be the best, but I'll try to explain them as best as I can. Because this language interacts with the content and isn't the content in itself, you would think to put it in the head tag. However, you need to think about the amount of people that will be visiting this site and the amount of data that could potentially be on the site, and consider efficiency. If someone goes to your site and it takes a long time to load, they might hit the back button and never even get to your site. Web browsers download and show the content of an HTML file from top to bottom, and JavaScript doesn't appear on your page like CSS does, so it can be loaded in later. While the size of your JavaScript file can be a small amount, sometimes it can make a difference. So, to be as efficient as possible, it's recommended to include your JavaScript just before you close your body tag, so the actual content and style appears before the functionality. As mentioned before, you should first have a goal in mind before learning specifics, but I'll try to explain the concepts. JavaScript is a powerful language that has much more than I know to offer. But there are extensions to the language called libraries. One of the most popular today, JQuery, allows you to do more by writing less. It attempts to extend JavaScript by adding functions to commonly used features of JavaScript. To extend even more, there are JQuery libraries that allow you to do specific functions. To include these in your site, you need to include them after the jQuery library, because browsers download and read websites from top to bottom, and jQuery plugins depend on jQuery to be present. Because jQuery is meant to simplify JavaScript, I'll explain some basic concepts of jQuery. JavaScript code must be wrapped in script tags. First, you need to select an element in your HTML. The syntax of jQuery is to begin with a dollar sign, followed by the selector in parentheses and quotes. So, selecting an H2 tag in jQuery would look like this. Now that you've specified what you want to be interacted with, you can add functionality with the dot operator, or a period. jQuery is huge, so you should search for something when you have a goal in mind. But for demonstration, I know that there is a click function that I can append to the selector, so that would look like this. This tells the browser that when an H2 tag is clicked, I want it to do what is specified in the parentheses after click. Within those parentheses, I want a function to occur, which can be indicated with the word function, followed by parentheses. The contents within this set of parentheses are called parameters, and they are optional and can be read about using the link in the description. After this set of parentheses, you can now create the function within two curly brackets. As this is just a demonstration, I will use a JavaScript function called alert to make sure the code is written right. To do this, I just write alert, open parentheses, what I want to be alerted inside quotes, and then close parentheses. After each function, you must indicate it's finished with a semicolon. This is very important and can drive you crazy when you forget it. Because this video is just an introduction to learning the basic concepts of jQuery, I'm not going to get into specific functions. If you need something specific, search for it, and it's probably already been done before. But if you've got a question you want me to answer, just ask it in the comments section and I'll try to respond as soon as I can. Click on the on-screen link or the first link in the video description to see how to use Jekyll to make your website building process easier. Thanks for watching.